Hello students, I'm here to revise on the topic covered for the term. And the topic as stated below. Number one, you have a chemical combination. Secondly, acid, bases and salt. Thirdly, chemistry of carbon and its compound. So looking at the first topic, which is chemical combination. Chemical combination means, owing to the electronic configuration as that of the noble gases, elements, when an element or a compound is said to attain the stable octet or duplet structure, as seen in the noble gas, is said to undergo a process known as chemical combination. So chemical combination is either the transfer or the sharing of electrons between one atom or element to the other to attain the stable octet or duplet structure, as seen in the noble gas, is referred to as chemical combination. And examples of such elements, that is the noble gas element, we have helium, argon, and krypton, xenon, that is for other complex elements. So now, we'll be looking at chemical combination is divided into two. Mainly, we have the electrovalent combination and the covalent combination. Covalent combination is subdivided into ordinary covalent and coordinate covalent. So looking at the first one, which is electrovalent combination. Electrovalent combination is the transfer of electrons from highly electropositive elements, example sodium, to a highly electronegative element, example chlorine, to form the stable octet or duplet structure. Is termed as electrovalent combination. That is, so, like I said, it's a transfer of electrons from highly electropositive element, example sodium, to highly electronegative element, chlorine, to attain the stable octet or duplet structure. So, for an element to be stable, it must attain the octet or duplet structure. Example, e.g., in helium atom. Helium is having atomic number 2. So therefore, it will give out the two electrons. It will give out the two electrons out easily. Also, for example, in sodium atom, sodium is having atomic number 11. That is, the outermost shell electron, we are having one electron. As stated below, so the electronic shell for sodium atom, the K shell will take maximum number of 2 electrons, the L shell will take maximum of 8 electrons, and electrons are arranged singly before we pair. So we arrange them singly before we pair them. So 2 plus 8 making 10, then the last electron is placed in the outermost shell. So it's the last electron in sodium atom that will combine with to the electronegative element that is in chlorine. Chlorine atoms have an atomic number 17. So K shell in chlorine will take maximum number of 2 electrons. L shell will take maximum number of 8 electrons. M shell will take another 8. L shell will take 7 electrons. So now, this electron in the outermost shell of sodium is transferred to the chlorine shell, electronic shell, that is to pair with the one electron in chlorine, so that will form a bond known as electrovalent bonding is formed. Which leads to the formation of sodium chloride. So once the outermost shell electron from the sodium atom is being transferred to that in the chlorine atom, we are going to form an electrovalent bonding. How? Because sodium is electropositive, it transfers this electropositive electron to chlorine, and chlorine pairs the electron. So once sodium transfers its outermost shell electron from its outermost shell electron from to what? Chlorine atom. Yeah. Number of electrons left in the outermost shell is 8. So when we are having 8 electrons in the outermost shell, it's referred to as octet. And for an element or a compound to be stable, it must attain the octet. Since one electron is being transferred, so the outermost shell now is contained, is left with 8 electrons, which means octet structure in sodium. So since sodium is transferred electron, it will take positive charge. And chlorine now is the one accepting. So and chlorine, since we are having its accepted electron from sodium, the outermost shell is now filled to what? 8 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you can equally see for that of chlorine atom, we are having octet structure also. So once sodium transfers electron, it takes positive charge, that is losing an electron. Chlorine accepts the electron, that is gaining the electron, it takes negative charge. And once the sodium ion combines with the chloride ion, we are going to form sodium chloride. So this is the diagrammatic representation which leads to the formation of sodium chloride, which is NaCl. Similarly, that is helium, or again, lithium chloride, that is formation of lithium chloride. Lithium is having atomic number 3. So since it's having atomic number 3, K shell of lithium will take 2 electrons, L, 1. The outermost shell electron in lithium is 1. It combines with chlorine atom. Chlorine is having atomic number 17. So chlorine, the K shell will take 2 electrons, L shell 8, then M shell 7. So which means the outermost shell electron in lithium will take 1 electron, then the outermost shell electron in chlorine, we are having 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Because electrons are arranged singly before we pair. So this outermost shell electron in lithium will be transferred to that in chlorine. Since the outermost shell electron in lithium is transferred to chlorine, so the lithium will take only 2 electrons, that is in the K shell. Because this L shell is accommodated with the 1 electron. So since it transfers the outermost shell electron from lithium, it's being transferred from lithium to chlorine, it means 2 electrons are left in lithium atom, which means it will taking a positive charge. It's losing an electron, and chlorine is gaining, it's taking a negative charge. And since chlorine gains the electron from lithium, formerly its outermost shell electrons was 7. Gaining 1 electron is equal to 8. So it has attained the octet structure. Okay. Also, lithium has attained the duplex by losing an electron. Chlorine has attained the octet structure by gaining an electron. So therefore, once we combine lithium ion with chloride ion, we are going to form lithium chloride. So we move to the next one, which is covalent combination. Covalent combination is the sharing of equal number of electrons between atoms of the same element or atoms of different element, e.g. And covalent combination can be divided into two. We have ordinary covalent and the coordinates covalent. Start with ordinary covalent combination. Ordinary covalent combination is the sharing of equal number of electrons between atoms of the same element. For instance, e.g. chlorine molecule formation. For chlorine molecule to be formed, chlorine atom must share equal number of electrons with another chlorine atom. For instance, the atomic shell of chlorine atom we are having 7 electrons. That is, K shell will take 2 electrons, L8, then the remaining 7 is placed in the atomic shell. This is example of chlorine atom with another chlorine atom. K shell take 2 electrons, L8 electrons, then the atomic shell we are having 7. So now, these electrons is being shared between each of these chlorine atoms, so that will form a bond, there will be a union between each of the chlorine atom. And each of these electrons in the atom, since we say the sharing of equal number of electron pair, this atomic electron is being shared between each of these chlorine atoms to form a chlorine molecule. So other kinds of bonding, other kinds of bonding we have is also, we are also having hydrogen bonding, van der Waals forces, and van der Waals forces is termed as the weak intermolecular force of attraction that exists between noble gas molecule. Example, we have helium, argon, krypton, and xenon. So for hydrogen bonding, it exists between a highly electropositive metal with electronegative metal. For hydrogen bonding, by explaining briefly, when hydrogen combines with a fluorine molecule, we are going to have hydrogen fluoride. So for instance, hydrogen will bond, having a strong bond with fluorine. Then fluorine, hydrogen, weak bond. Then hydrogen to fluorine, another strong bond. Fluorine to hydrogen, weak bond. So this weak bond stems out the van der Waals forces. Because it's the weak bond that helps a hydrogen and an electronegative element, for instance, fluorine, which leads to the formation of hydrogen fluoride. Also, in water molecules, since water molecule is the combination of 2 atoms of hydrogen and 1 atom of oxygen, formation of water, hydrogen to oxygen bond is a strong bond, oxygen to hydrogen is a weak bond. Then hydrogen to oxygen, strong bond, oxygen to hydrogen, weak bond. So we can easily form water from this. Then also here, water. 2 atoms of hydrogen, 1 atom of oxygen. The weak bond, the dash braces signifies the weak bond, which is the van der Waals forces.